Good morning, everyone. Today we are going to continue the study of development. We have to study here today about the average income method to compare the different countries or states. How we can compare the different countries or states? Before that, I want to know that how we compare the development of personal development. We can say that increase in marks. We can say that I have improved my studies because my marks are improved. Or if our standard of living improved or increased, that is also one of the signs of development. How can we say that our standard of living is increased? By we can analyzing that the facilities, luxuries we have in our house, or the comforts which we have purchased in our house, or our increase in the salary or increase in income. So that we can understand that we have a personal development, increase in income, increase in studies, or increase in educational records. We can say that my personal development is increased. Same way, we can analyze the development of different states, different countries, by looking into certain attributes or certain features. As we say that income is one of the important attributes or one of the important factor which we take into consideration for studying development. Income, when we study about income, average income is used to compare the countries or to compare different states or countries. We take average income as one of the important attribute for this development study. Average income is also known as per capita income. So average income, another name we can say, it is known as per capita income. So how can we find out average income or per capita income? The way to find out it is known as, it is the sum total of the income of the country divided by its total population. That means sum total of the income of the country. Income from every sectors we can take divided by its population. It is known as average income or per capita income. And World Development Reports, it is brought about by the World Bank, which classifies the countries based on it, on this average income criteria. Mainly World Bank, which is one of the important international organizations which study the, which compare the development of countries. In that, World Bank take average income to compare the development of different countries. And the reports which World Bank brought or brings, that is known as, or the reports which published by World Bank, which is known as World Development Report. In that, World Bank classifies the countries based on average income. According to that, they had, or World Bank had classified the countries into two categories, that is rich countries and poor countries, or low, less income countries. Rich countries in the sense countries with a per capita income of US$12,236 per annum or above, which is known as rich income countries. And countries with per capita income less than US$1,005, which is known as low income countries. So, World Bank classification of countries are into rich income countries and low income countries. Amount is used as per capita income for the study of the World Bank. World Bank development or the development study. And the rich income, which means more than $12,236 per annum, which is taken as, which is considered as rich income countries or rich countries, and the low income countries in the sense less than 1,005. India belongs to low middle income countries because its per capita income is only 1,840 per annum, US$1,840 per annum. So India, according to World Bank report, India is in the low middle income countries. We could see that there are many countries which have more than this per capita income. So these countries are in the rich countries. For example, Middle East countries, which are rich countries. Okay, children. Look at this table. We can see the per capita income of certain states given here. Haryana, Kerala, Bihar. Here we can see the per capita income for 2015-16 in rupees it is given. In your textbook, it can be the digits can be or the number can be varied. You refer your textbook whichever is the edition, new edition. Haryana, we could see it's the per capita income is more, but we can see the per capita income of Kerala is slight less than Haryana, and Bihar it is much lower than Haryana and Kerala. So per capita income of these three states, which we can see the per capita income of Haryana is much higher than Kerala and Bihar. From that we can understand the thing that Haryana is more developed than Kerala and Bihar. Is it right? Means we study per capita income as one of the attributes for measuring development. We can see from this table that Haryana is more developed. But if we analyze the second table, we can see that per capita income, other than per capita income, there are many other things which we have to consider. One is infant mortality rate. Infant mortality rate means the children with, that die below 1 year or less than 1 year they die. That infant mortality rate is much higher in Haryana, that is 36 live birth. And in Kerala it is much less, 12 only. And in Bihar again it's the it is more or most it is more than Haryana and Kerala. So here we can say that infant mortality rate is much lower in Kerala, while infant mortality rate of the other two states are higher. Let's take about the next attribute, that is literacy rate. Literacy rate, one who can be able to read and write in his or her mother tongue, it is known as literacy rate. Literacy rate, when we consider, we can see among these three states, Kerala stands at the top because it has, Kerala has more literacy rate than Haryana and Bihar. That is the second attribute. Let's take the next third attribute, that is net attendance ratio. Net attendance ratio, that means between the age of 14, 40 to 15 years, children who the number of children they take admission, or total number of children in between 14 to 15 years they attend the school. That is, as a percentage of total number of children in the same age group, we can say that the net attendance ratio of Haryana and Bihar are much lower, and Kerala it is higher, 83, which shows that Kerala has more attendance ratio, net attendance ratio, more literacy rate, and less infant mortality rate. From this analysis of these two tables, we can see one is per capita income, one is the other attributes, which are infant mortality rate, literacy rate, net attendance ratio, etc. Can we say that Haryana is more developed? No, because Haryana has more per capita income. At the same time, the other attributes like infant mortality rate, literacy rate, net attendance ratio, which are too much variation from the Kerala. So this is one of the analysis we can understand. If we compare Kerala, Haryana, Kerala and Bihar, we can say that Haryana has more per capita income than Kerala. But if we compare other attributes of the states, we can say that literacy rate, infant mortality rate, net attendance ratio, Kerala is more developed. So if we consider Bihar, which is least developed, because it has less per capita income and less net attendance ratio, more infant mortality rate, at the same time less, say, less literacy rate. So we can say that many attributes we can take into consideration for development. It does not mean income alone. This we can understand from this analysis. Now let's study one thing, that is the importance of public facilities. As we know that people, they have money, lot of money we have, but sometimes we are helpless. As we know that the present time, that is many rich people, even though they have money, much money, but they can't get oxygen. Due to that, they die. So they have money, but oxygen deficiency, due to that, they die. That is one of the critical things that is going on now. That means that money in our pocket cannot buy sometimes everything what we need to live. And sometimes we are helpless even though we have more money in our pocket. It does not mean that all the time money can support us, but sometimes even though we have a lot of money, we are helpless in some certain situation. One thing that is a pollution-free environment, we cannot buy pollution-free environment with a lot of money. That is where we are helpless. And unadulterated medicines. Medicines we can consume, but it should be pure medicines. And unadulterated, or without any mix, without any adulteration, some medicines we cannot get. Even though we have spent a lot of money for medicines, we cannot say that we have used or we have consumed unadulterated medicines. This in this we are helpless. Many times we could see that money cannot protect us from infectious diseases or contagious diseases. We cannot. We are helpless when we have some epidemic recently. Now the present situation is like that. The COVID-19, which is spreading everywhere, and we are helpless even though we have money. So, contagious diseases or epidemic infectious diseases, money cannot protect us. These are the things that we have enough money, but sometimes we are helpless. Next thing that, so importance of public facilities is one of the important area to discuss. Public facilities, which is given by the government. So, role of government is very important in providing public facilities. One thing that public facilities, for example, government school, government hospitals, then public transportation, many things are there that government can give. Water supply, electricity, everything government gives. These public facilities are affordable for everyone. All people can afford it. It is cheap and best. Private facilities are very expensive. If we depend upon these facilities in private, it is very expensive. Same thing, we can say that now we have analyzed from the table, we have analyzed that Kerala has low infant mortality rate, more net attendance ratio, more literacy ratio. Why it is? Because Kerala, we can say that the adequate provision is given for public health and educational facilities. Government take initiative to provide health and nutritional and educational facilities. That is why Kerala proves much above than other states. But some states we could see even public distribution system which works well. That in the sense the public distribution system rationing, which works well in some of the states like Tamil Nadu, Andhra Pradesh, many such states, it works well. Due to that, people are deprived of poverty, or people get nutritious food, and also poverty is much less. So from this analysis, we can say that role of public facilities is very important in providing the development, or in bringing development.